What's the best GPS dog tracker? I put Halo, SpotOn, and Fi to the ultimate GPS test. I strapped these babies on to do some field testing. Two of these are GPS fences, so there's a chance I got shocked in the neck.
There's the bell. Yep.
But what are we looking for in a GPS collar? Well, two things: precision and update frequency. How exact is the location, and how reliably is that reflected on your phone screen? If you decide to buy any of these GPS dog trackers, don't forget to check the description for any sweet offers or coupon codes. I have links to all three products there as well. SpotOn and Halo are invisible fences. They're built to step in for a physical fence when the real thing isn't so practical. And Fi is a fitness tracker with GPS, more like a Fitbit for your dog. When it comes to tracking location, all three can do it. If you're living that apartment life without a yard, you probably don't need a virtual fence. Got a yard? Cool. But unless it's at least a half an acre, these GPS fences might not be your best bet. SpotOn even spells it out on their website. Now, I've tested them on smaller areas and they work, but with GPS drift, it's not ideal when you consider how much freedom your dog has to roam. The new Halo 3 claims to cover a smaller yard. We're testing it out as I film this, so stay tuned. And hey, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss it. Now, let's say you don't need a fence, but you're in the market for a GPS tracker for your dog. Fi could be your go-to, it's easier on your wallet, and it's not designed to be a fence. But hold your horses! If pinpoint accuracy and frequent location updates are high on your list, well then, we're in for an interesting discussion. Let's unpack that. Location accuracy comes down to two main factors: where that antenna is sitting on the collar, and then all the techie stuff. The number of satellites it connects to, the technology it employs, and how it deals with typical GPS issues. Now, for GPS to work, the antenna needs a clear view of the sky. Halo's design gives no clear indicator as to where the GPS is located, but they do tell you to wear it with the Halo logo facing down. So let's guess that the GPS sits directly opposite of that. Now, on the Halo 2 Plus, the leash hook is a little bit off-center. Anyone who's taken a dog for a walk knows that's a bit odd. In any case, Halo is designed to act as an invisible fence, so the leash is sort of optional. SpotOn sidesteps this issue by not having a leash hook at all. The collar itself is all about being a GPS fence, and it shows. The GPS is clearly marked, and it enjoys a nice, clear view of the sky. Points for form meeting function. As for Fi, the tech is all packed into this tiny device. The band's just here to be a band, but similar to previous Halo models, the leash hook's placement can make the device sit a little bit off-center. Now, each brand has a fancy name for their GPS tech, and each claims theirs is the most accurate. They can't all be the most accurate, now can they? Halo dubs theirs Precision GPS. According to their website, they're linked up to 127 satellites across 6 networks. SpotOn connects to 128 satellites, part of 4 global systems. They claim this multi-satellite connection gives them a leg up on the competition and yields 3-foot accuracy on your dog's location. SpotOn separates its GPS and cell antennas, which allegedly improves the accuracy. Plus, they add a sprinkle of AI to track your dog's speed and direction, and even include a specialized forest mode for improved tracking in the woods. Now, Fi operates on 3 satellite systems with a total of 78 satellites, locating your dog within a 6-foot radius. But they also use data from your phone to save battery. Fi is cheaper and isn't responsible for keeping your dog fenced in, so they can cut a few corners without too much fuss. Look, the invisible fences communicate with your dog through alerts or even static corrections. Basically shocks.
Oh god, whoa!
So if the GPS is wonky, you're just confusing your dog, or worse, hurting them. That's why SpotOn, who used to make tech for the US military, is going all in on precision. We'll test how well that works shortly. For any of this to work, these collars need to talk to your phone. In the case of Fi and Halo, that requires a cell subscription. If you have wanderlust and travel internationally, Halo has all carrier global coverage at no extra charge. SpotOn can run without a cell subscription if you just need the fencing function. All right, time for some action. I wore the collars on myself so that I can speak for the pups. With Halo and SpotOn, I sketched out fences first and tested their static corrections by trying to escape. I think that's the real test of GPS precision for them. Let's roll with Halo. They promised 2 distinct warnings before the collar issues a correction.
All right, so here's the Halo collar. There's the warning. Don't want to chicken out again, but hopefully we'll get that boundary before we get the static. There's the boundary. All right, so let's turn around. All right, and we're good.
It worked as advertised, although that warning was so quiet, I doubt you caught it.
There's the warning. I'm gonna continue on to get to the boundary. Hopefully it doesn't shock me. There's the bell. There's the bell.
So I tried again. Big mistake. Got zapped without the second warning. Yep, that stung. Now SpotOn. I've always seen them nail it, so it was weird when they jumped the gun on the second warning.
And this is the SpotOn. There's the alert. Oh, and it's correcting right now. I'll be honest, I turned off the static correction because I didn't want to get shocked anymore. So no warning there either.
Gave them another chance and it worked like a charm. Two warnings and time to retreat.
There's the alert. There's the warning. Now I could go further, but I'm not gonna because I don't want to get shocked again. All right, let's back up. And we're safe again.
For Fi, I decided to go for a walk. All right, so I just took my first walk with the Fi collar here, and what I'm seeing is that it does track reasonably well. There's definitely a bit of a delay. The location doesn't update instantly, far from instantly, I would say. And if you look at the map, you can see that it's not tracking instantaneously. I went around a circle up here, and what you're seeing is really more of a diamond shape, so it's not really precisely tracking that location, but it is tracking steps. It does, you know, plot the route reasonably well. It was certainly reliable for the purpose that it serves. I did also do some step counting, you know, very close agreement there between the Apple phone and what the Fi collar is reading, so pretty happy to see that.
So, the verdict? In the precision race, SpotOn and Halo have an edge over Fi, thanks to their fancier tech. But remember, it took some calibration to get the Halo 2 Plus on point, while SpotOn was good to go right off the bat. We'll see how the Halo 3 handles this soon, so remember to stay tuned for that video. In my previous experiments, SpotOn has been more reliable. Halo has unexpectedly zapped me countless times, even within the safe zone. As for update frequency, SpotOn is almost real time. Halo can keep up when properly calibrated. Fi, they're at a leisurely 30-second update pace or so. If we're talking pure specs and performance, SpotOn steals the show. No contest there. But here's the kicker. Do you need a PlayStation just to watch Netflix? SpotOn's hefty price tag, around $1,300 as I'm filming, with an optional monthly cell subscription of up to about $10, is completely justified for the high-end product that they're offering. But it makes it a hard sell for those who just want basic GPS tracking. You're splurging on a full-fledged GPS fence system, so unless you have a pup with a knack for escapism and a big yard, you might be overshooting. And the same goes for Halo, which is priced at around $700 as I'm filming, and requires a monthly subscription fee ranging from $6 to $30. And then there's our underdog Fi. It may not have the pinpoint precision of its more sophisticated counterparts, but let's be real, for the everyday tasks of finding your runaway dog or checking their walking route, Fi gets the job done, and it doesn't break the bank. So, before you jump the gun and add to cart, consider what you really need.